I think we can all agree that breathing is important. So important that when you were born, it was one of the first actions you took, followed by a lot of crying. Fast forward 5 years later, as you are playing hide and seek at recess. Suddenly, you start coughing and wheezing. Then you realize that you're unable to breathe. You can only take little half breaths and develop feelings of chest tightness. These, my friends, are some of the symptoms of having an asthma attack. Asthma is often defined as a chronic inflammatory disorder of the airways. So what does that mean? Well, normally our body has an amazing filtering system for the air we breathe that starts at our nose. Our nose secretes this thick and sticky substance called mucus that traps unwanted particles like dirt, pollen, or smoke. Think of it almost like your favorite fly trapper. Small hairs called cilia also move in wave-like motions, pushing the mucus to the back of our throat, where it either gets swallowed or spit out. Have you ever noticed a lot of post-nasal drip during pollen season? As irritating as it can be, that is your nose working overtime to clear out the pollen before it reaches your lungs. This is completely normal in our body's way of protecting us from particles that may contain bacteria or viruses that can cause illnesses. This leads us to what happens in patients with asthma. The body's inflammatory system goes into overdrive. This occurs when the immune system is exposed to something called an allergen or trigger, such as pollen, pet dander, smoke, or mold. It mistakenly tags this as something bad by producing antibodies to it called IgE. Upon re-exposure to the same allergen, the body's hyperinflammatory system remembers the allergen and causes the release of IgE antibodies that bind to and activate mast cells. Mast cells are a type of immune cell that function as the body's first line of defense against harmful allergens preventing them from entering the body. They do this by releasing granules that contain things such as histamine, prostaglandin, and leukotriene. These mediators go on to cause constriction of the airway smooth muscles and increase mucus production. This process is something called the early asthmatic response. This is followed 3 to 6 hours later by a late asthmatic response, where pro-inflammatory cytokine proteins recruit and activate additional immune cells such as eosinophils that join in on the fun of contributing to continued and sustained bronchoconstriction and mucus production. These series of events lead to symptoms of asthma, including wheezing, breathlessness, chest tightness, and coughing. In asthma, the smooth muscles around your airway tighten and shrink and become more narrow, leading to chest tightness. In addition, overproduction of mucus produces mucus plugs throughout the lining of the airway that can cause coughing. This makes it tough to move air through and almost causes a whistling sound as air passes through the narrow space. This is known as wheezing. The narrow and inflamed airways not only lead to decreased oxygenation, but also decreased ventilation as air gets trapped inside the lungs. The increased work of breathing to get air in and out can lead to exhaustion and breathlessness as seen in patients with asthma. So how is it diagnosed? In addition to the patient's symptoms, medical history, and physical exam, physicians commonly use a spirometer to diagnose asthma. A spirometer is a device used to measure the volume of air inspired and expired by the lungs. A physician will have a patient use the spirometer after administering a medication called a beta agonist,
which we will discuss in a separate video in the link above.
If there is an improvement in the spirometry readings after using the beta agonist, this is a good indication of asthma since it is reversible with medications unlike COPD. Once the diagnosis is confirmed, initial asthma management depends on how often they have symptoms, such as nighttime awakenings, the need for a rescue inhaler to control symptoms, activity limitations due to asthma, as well as daytime symptoms.